Hi, I'm Gabriel, and this is Learning English Path. And in this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to talk about life and ice cream. Life can be confusing. Is life countable or uncountable? Do we say life, a life, the life, my life, your life? Can there be more than one life? Life is an abstract noun, but there are many ways in which we can use this word. Take this sentence, for instance. Many people's lives are in danger, and we need to do our best to help them, because life is precious. So here, in one sentence, we have the uncountable noun for life and the countable noun for life. Life is precious. In this sense, life is uncountable because life is being alive, right? The very abstract essence of being alive. This is life. And there is much life on this planet, right? And we are searching for life on other planets. And so we have this definition of what life is, what it means to be alive. And we include that as one holistic term, life. But life becomes uncountable when we are talking about a specific individual's life or a specific organism's life. An organism can be any one living thing that is working as a whole. So a person can be an organism. Is an organism. Any animal is one organism. Any one plant is one organism. Okay, so a tree is an organism. A rabbit is an organism. Okay, and a person is an organism. So, in this sense, each of those individual organisms have one life. So it becomes a noun in itself when it is possessed by an organism. So we have life, as in everything that is alive, and we have a life, as in the life that is possessed by a single organism. And that is what is countable. So that is why we can talk about lives. You see? So let's take this next paragraph. I'll give you a whole statement here. Because it gets a little bit more complicated too. Alright, so I'm going to read you this. My new life is exciting. Since I have moved to America, my love life has been great. I live life to the full. American life is very different from Indian life. Americans live fascinating lives. My new friends are so full of life. Okay, so here's life in a lot of different contexts, yeah? Now let's take a closer look. We say, this person said, my new life. My new life. So that means that you don't necessarily just have one life. You can have an old life and a new life, right? So it's an adjective before the abstract noun, life. And then the person says, my love life has been great. So we can have a love life, a working life, a student life, a personal life. There are many kinds of lives that a person can live. A person can have a secret life, right? And a public life. So one person's life can be divided into many different aspects as well. Many different portions of their whole life. Okay? And all we have to do there really is to define which one we're talking about. And an adjective is a very good way of doing this, but we can also just simply rename it, like love life, right? This person also says American life and Indian life, right? So these are adjectives. A person is American or Indian, or a culture is American or Indian, right? So these are adjectives that come before life. And what it does here is it doesn't just describe one person's life. It describes the lifestyle, specifically here, the cultural lifestyle. But an adjective here keeps the word life as uncountable. So before we had my new life. So this is countable because it's mine, right? You can say my new life, your new life. These are countable nouns. But here, the person is not just talking about his or her life anymore. They are talking about American life or Indian life. And this defines the whole culture, the whole lifestyle. And lifestyle is a specific way of living life, right? And finally, my friends, my new friends are so full of life. So full of life is an expression that describes how much vitality, how much energy the people have. So if you're full of life, it means you are not tired, you are not just living a boring life. You have energy, you have vitality, right? So that's full of life. What about love? Love, the noun, not the verb. So of course we can say, I love you. This means, this is the verb, something we do, right? Or she loves him. In that sense, that's a verb too. But the noun, the abstract noun love, also is an interesting word when it comes to whether it's countable or uncountable. We can say love is a beautiful thing. In this case, love is an uncountable noun, right? Because this is how we define the general emotion of love that people feel all around the world, right? So in that sense, you might think, well, so there's just one love. But again, when it's possessed by different people, it becomes their own. So it becomes countable. So for example, maybe two people love the same woman. Two men love the same woman. One man might say, my love for you is stronger than his love. So there are two loves going on, right? That's because, again, when love is possessed by different people, they become different nouns. So his love, her love, my love, your love, right? So it becomes countable. You might say, she is the love of my life. That's, again, countable, the love, right? And you might also say, I have many loves in my life. My wife, my job, and coffee, okay? And you might know already that in ancient Greece, they had words for many different kinds of love. At least four different types of love, maybe more, right? So when you're talking about different kinds of love as well, then it can become a countable noun. So different kinds, love by held by different people, and of course your love for different things or different parts of your life or different people. It's kind of like ice cream. You might say, I want ice cream, or I want an ice cream. Or you could say, I'll have two ice creams, please. All of those are okay. Why is that? Well, ice cream is an uncountable noun, right? You can have a lot of ice cream or a little bit of ice cream because you don't have to measure it any specific way, right? It's not like an apple where you can have one apple, two apples, three apples, okay? You can have a lot of ice cream at once. But when you divide ice cream into portions, like perhaps one scoop of ice cream, or one ice cream cone, or one lollipop on a stick, right? Then it becomes countable because it's one portion. Similarly, you could think of life and love in the same way. Life is one big tub of ice cream. And you can have a lot of it, or you can have a little bit of it. And love, you can have lots of love in your life, like you can eat lots of ice cream, or you can have just a little bit. But when one person feels one portion of love for someone else, then it becomes countable. And when one organism has one life, it becomes countable. Okay? So when it's divided, it becomes countable. And with ice cream, you have lots of different flavors, right? You have chocolate, strawberry, vanilla. Now they've got some crazy flavors like peanut butter and banana with cookie dough, something, right? You can have lots of different types of ice cream, and there are lots of different types of love. And there's also lots of different types of life. Like we already said before, right? Lifestyles. These are different types of life. when you put adjectives before them or after them. Like you could say a free life or a life of freedom. So if you're describing life in a certain way, then can become countable because it's a type of life, a type of love, a type of ice cream. Let me know if you found this useful. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, comment, subscribe. If you subscribe, you'll get lots more lessons like this. I have a lot of much deeper English lessons planned for you. I have some playful ones too. All right, my goal for this channel is to have a lot of playful videos, but also a lot more deep English lessons that will be coming out shortly. Okay, I want to take this into directions that are not explored by other English channels on YouTube. My goal is to help you on your path. I want you to live a greater life. So stick with me and keep going.